Okay, so this is take two on the rainbow cup. Let's see how this one plays out, because yesterday was a total fail. I'm going to use all the same colors. The Brea Reese Cadmium Red, Orange, Yellow, Cobalt Green. Then we're going to do Lake Blue, Ultramarine, and then Purple. So I'm going to lay these out in order off to the side here just to make it easier for me. Yesterday, my spacing was all kinds of wrong. So what I've decided this time is I'm going to do the red, and then halfway down, I'm going to do the green, and then halfway down, I'm going to do the purple. And I think I figured out where I went wrong yesterday. I think I had my epoxy too thick, too runny, too warm. So this time, I put a little cosmic additive in there. This is from Franz. It is super duper fine. I'll open it really gently here. Super duper fine powder. It does not take much. I used about a half of one of these little paddle scoops right there. Probably less than half of that. And it made plenty of sparkle here. So, here we go. And I think I figured out something else I want to do different too. So I'm going to only drop from the back side of the cup right there so that it controls a little bit better. I feel like part of my problem yesterday was that I dripped it straight on and it just allowed too much of the gravity to take over. See how that's already spreading? I think that was a big part of my problem yesterday. And I'm not worried about those lines being straight, but I am worried about getting that white all the way covered up there. Either with ink onto the base paint or spreading the epoxy. So I'm going to say this is about halfway. This is where the curve of the cup is. So I'm going to do that all the way around. In a minute, I'm also going to drizzle the white. I forgot to mention I've got epoxy with epoxy dye in it over here off to the side waiting in the wings. So that is that. We're going to let that swirl for a bit while we work on purple. Now on the purple, I need to also take it all the way down the end. So, this one I'm going to kind of just drop right here down the side here, and then I'll go and do it down the back side. Yep, that's pretty much enough to cover that. I definitely feel like I've got lots more room. Since I am going so much bigger this time. So I'm going to bring this up just a bit. So I have my cup base painted white. You can kind of see my logo here every once in a while. That's kind of irritating me because I definitely sanded that thing all the way off. Okay. So that's all I'm going to do on the purple. At least for now. Putting the lid back on. I am going to go ahead and go back over this right here. Okay. Let that kind of solidify again. It was kind of starting to get that little breakup effect. And that's okay. This doesn't have to be perfect. I saw a cup months ago. And I found it again. I went on Pinterest and searched in rainbow cup. And that thing is just gorgeous. Oh man, that went all over the place. And that cup is just gorgeous. So that is the inspiration I'm using for this cup. I feel like that needs another drip right over here. Yeah, okay. That's it for that. My green is a little bigger than I wanted because some of those got a little out of hand. So we are going to do orange, the O of our ROYGBIV. I'll let that spread a bit. I'll go ahead and give it our yellow. Make sure you're working over a protected surface unless you're just literally working in an area that really doesn't matter at all. Which some of us do have that ability. Not everybody. So now I'm going to do the lake blue right here. I'm actually going to go over some of this green in some spots because I definitely took it down a little further than I intended. And hopefully going over it with the blue will kind of check it a bit. No, not really. I still got a lot of green right there. That's probably where I'll put whatever vinyl I decide to do, is right there in that kind of weird spot right there. It happens. So now we're going to do ultramarine, aka indigo. This is almost identical, if not identical. It might be exactly the same. From Tim Holtz brand. I did a drop side by side of them and they looked identical. Well, it looks like my lake blue might disappear by the time it's all said and done. We'll see. I'm about to add some white drips. We're gonna do little drizzles and then I'm gonna throw my mask on and we're gonna heat it up. So my bottom is pretty much covered. I've just got one little spot that's kind of breaking up. And that's okay. I like that cosmic in here because it definitely gives it just enough shimmer. But it's not overwhelming. Alright, so I have this. It's literally just some epoxy that has now thickened up a little bit. Possibly too much. We'll see. And I'm just going to drizzle it right in between the colors best as I can. I don't really want big clumps, but I'm sure it'll happen. It's kind of hard to get this on here just right, and if you're not careful, it kind of looks a little gross. It's like some snot rockets all over. So I've got my heat gun handy. I forgot to plug it in, so I'm going to do that in just a second. But, get these on here first. Dang it, I put that in the wrong spot because of that weird line right there. So last night I had my epoxy a little too hot, so this really blended. It wasn't supposed to blend in the way that it did, because I lost pretty much most of my general design to that. That's okay. It's really pretty, the one from last night. It is just not anywhere close to what I was going for. But that's okay, because pretty much every cup that I've made that was an oops cup, actually not pretty much, every cup that I've made that was an oops cup has sold. They usually sell faster than my on-purpose cups, which is weird, but that's how it goes. Okay, so I'm going to throw my mask on now and plug that in. I don't really want this overheated because I don't want it going crazy, but I'm going to make some swirls in there, so I definitely need it blended pretty good. Oops. Okay, got that. Make sure when you're heating epoxy, you are protected because these are chemicals and you gotta be safe. I've been known to have several reactions because I was stupid. So I'm just going to zap this in a way that makes it nice and runny, but not super duper liquefied. I'm just using this right here, by the way. I'm hoping that when I swirl this in a minute, it'll kind of make that white kind of blend a little bit. You can kind of see on screen the parts that are moving to see exactly where I'm blasting at the moment. Alright. That's more than runny enough. Make sure when you set down your heat gun, you don't accidentally put it somewhere that could catch fire. That would be bad. Those tips are hot. As I say that, my schnauzer walks up and decides to get a little too close for my comfort, so go figure. So, now, I may ruin this right now, but I'm going to take my finger right there, and I'm going to just kind of swirl it. Don't really want to mix all my colors up, so I'm going to wipe it off after each one. And then I'm going to heat this back up again in a minute. I may actually end up dabbing this. I don't know if you've seen any of my other videos where I actually like pat the colors down onto everything. I kind of blend them a little more. I may end up doing that on this one. Such a cool overall look. Just wanted to make that white. Kind of swirled in there. The inspiration cup I'm using, or the cup I'm using for my inspiration, is got like a little swirl in between. And since this has so much right here, I'm gonna see if I can't kind of break that up just a bit. I'm about to heat this up, so it won't look like little frosting lines afterwards. But it kind of gets some of that off of there. Okay, so I'm going to heat it up again, kind of get that smoothed out. Again, I may have just ruined this, but we'll see. Rotate this, make it turn the other direction. And change up our swirl pattern just a little bit. I just blew on it just with my regular breath to kind of cool it off a little bit.
Okay, I'm gonna let that kind of sit, rotate for a little while, kind of thicken up a bit, kind of go from there. I think when this is all said and done, I'm gonna do that little pat technique. I love the way it looks, it's so cool looking. I do kind of feel like we need, I'm probably gonna regret this, but I feel like it needs it for sure. I've lost almost all my orange. And of course now it's gonna overtake my yellow. If I can't throw a little bit more of this little pretty blue in the middle here. See if it can kind of stand out on its own. I've got a few little dabs of green right there. Don't like it. These are from earlier when I was kind of swirling. I didn't get my glove cleaned off enough. Why do I keep messing these up? I could just stop touching it. It'd probably be a survivor, if I had to bet. Looks pretty. I can do that right here too. This is gonna smooth out a good bit after it has turned a while. It'll never look the way when you come back to them an hour from now. They never look the way they look now. And I'm just wiping my finger on a napkin now. Like it has a little swirl in it like that. It definitely shouldn't look like that. A little bubble in it. Yeah, this is really pretty. Once again, it's not exactly what I was going for, but it's pretty cute. I like it. So I'm going to heat this up just a little bit, just to kind of smooth down those little peaks right there. I'm actually going to do this too. I need to take some of this green out of here. All right, a little bit more. Okay. That's better. That's not so dark. That middle just got so dark. I definitely got way too much green ink right there. But that's okay. This is starting to definitely thicken up now. All right. What a mess. It's okay though. It's really pretty. Okay, so I'm gonna zap it with some more heat. It's definitely easy to scorch your epoxy if you're not careful. I don't think I've done it so far. Maybe I have and I just didn't realize I have. But I've got my heat gun about 6 inches from my cup. Some people actually use a real torch, like with flame. I do a lot of alcohol ink, so I'm not really interested in doing that for my own purposes, my own bubble popping reasons. But I know that is something that a lot of people do. I'm paranoid that alcohol inks are going to ignite. That's probably like a completely unrealistic thought. I'm just cooling off that epoxy a little faster. You can kind of see where it swirled real hard, real fast. You can kind of see that a little bit better there. It's really pretty overall. Kind of figuring out what I want to do on the decal on this one. I kind of want to put something that says like, be someone's rainbow, or I don't know. If you have any good suggestions, let me know. It's going to be a couple days before I even get remotely close to doing any kind of decal. But I'd be interested to hear what other people have to say, suggest on that. But once again, I've completely lost a color. You can't even tell that I had yellow, like, at all. If I tilt this cup this way, if I take it off and kind of tilt it, all of this will kind of smear and spread wrong. That's okay. It's not the end of the world. You can still definitely tell what it's supposed to be. So we'll come back and check on it in about an hour. I'm about to do a couple other little cup checks. So we'll see what it looks like in an hour. So I've decided I want to go ahead and pat it down. I really like the way it looks whenever I do that. So I'm just going to, I've got a fresh glove, very minimal glitter from just being in here. So I'm just going to do this. It's kind of thickening up, so kind of gives it more of a, not really a Monet look, but kind of that undefined edge effect. I just got my hand down in the bottom. That was not smart. Okay. So that's that for there. Bring this little chunk around here. Alright, so I'm going to wipe my finger off there really, really good. Continue on. Kind of break up those swirls just a little bit. Use a different finger this time. Oh, look, there's some of my yellow. Not trying to completely remove this, but it's definitely making some bald spots. I'm literally just tapping it like this, just gently. It looks a lot worse than it actually is because it's sticky and it's making my cup bounce. That's okay. This has such a big area to it that I'm just kind of going around and around. Almost done with the green. I'm curious what everybody listens to when they're doing their crafting. Do you listen to the radio? Do you listen to podcasts? I usually have some podcasts going. I try not to have anything that could be copyrighted or trademarked in these videos, though. So that's not really going to work out for this, but usually I'm listening to, I have a couple of favorite podcasts, kind of gotten on a true crime kick, but I really have a variety. If someone analyzed my podcast network, they'd probably be like, this one's a weirdo because she's listening to fairy tale retellings and true crime murder investigations. I probably have a heyday with breaking that apart. All right, so I'm gonna go different finger. I'll bring that up just a bit. Since I've got so much green I can overtake. I have a couple of movies that I can literally turn on and not even bother watching them. I've seen them so many times that I can literally play the movie in my head. It's really sad. I'll go ahead and admit I'm a twihard. It's a nerdy thing to admit, but I'm okay with it. I love that series so stinking much. It's stupid how much I love that series. I'm gonna get a fresh glove because that one's just about tacked out. Fresh paper towel. Elf is another one of those movies. I totally watched it 3 times in 1 day, not that long ago, just a couple weeks ago. I love it. Feel free to comment what you do whenever you're listening or when you're working. Are you listening to something? Are you watching something in the background? Are you one of those keep it quiet and concentrate kind of people? I'm curious. Harry Potters. All the Harry Potters. I could easily do that. But I love them so much that I actually sit down and watch them, even though I don't need to. So I actually don't get very much done if I try and choose a Harry Potter for the background. Princess Bride. That's another good one. We actually had a chicken named Princess Buttercup. I know exactly that everyone is like, ooh, I always wanted to know that. I have 13 chickens and they all have a fun little name. My youngest one's name is Curly Sue. It's one of the chickens with the curly feathers, and I just couldn't resist. I mean, you know your country when you get chickens for your birthday. And chicken decorations for every other holiday, including socks. I'd be interested. Oh, and I have two ducks. Sunshine and Midnight. They were really quacking loud outside the shed window just a minute ago. Not sure if they're going to be audible or not, but I would love to know who else out there has interesting little pets. We used to have pigs also. They just showed up at our house one day, and we found the owners about five houses down. And then they showed up again a few weeks later. Took them home. Then they showed up again. Took them home. And then the last time that they did that, we're like, hey, if you can't keep hold of them, keep them contained, we'll be glad to keep them. And so the very last time, they're like, you can have them because we clearly can't do this. So we had Bill and Ted for a little while. We ended up finding them a home with a family that had more pigs to play with. Okay, so I'm done. I'm not going to do anything else to this tap-wise. I'm just going to heat it just a bit because I do have some air bubbles because of that motion. But after that heat, that's it. I'm not touching it again. I promise. But I'm not overdoing it on the heat this time. I don't really want a lot of movement. Just trying to pop those air bubbles, and that looks pretty good. Bottom is good. I like having the little dabs on there. Maybe not everybody does, but I like having the dabs because it almost gives it like a watercolor vibe. Not exactly watercolor, but that's kind of the gist that it brings to mind. So we're going to let that rotate for a couple of hours. I'll come take a picture of it in a little bit to post on the video thumbnail, but we've got our distinct colors. We lost most of the yellow, but that's okay. We've got the red, we've got the orange, we've got a little yellow, tons of green. Blue, indigo, violet. So we've got all of our colors represented there. So recap. Cadmium red. There we go. Orange. Cadmium yellow. Cobalt green. Lake blue. Ultramarine. Purple. And then this is what I used for the little cup of white drizzle. Just a couple of drops in there. I actually got a little bit too much in there, but it's okay. So we're going to let this cure. If you've got any ideas for a decal to put on here, leave in the comments. I would love to have an idea going into it, because I don't like to decal same day. It'll probably be 2 days probably before I decal it. And if you see this and comment later, we'll use it for the next one, or maybe it'll give someone else an idea for their next rainbow cup. So anyways, if you have any questions, leave a comment. Please subscribe to my channel. That way you'll get notifications every time I upload something new. Kind of got a couple of irons in the fire right now. I'm in the middle of a cowhide application. You can probably see part one of the video already. uploaded. It's a couple videos below this one. I'll be working on that this weekend. And then I've got an alcohol ink cling wrap camo cup going. It's drying right now. We're on about 24 hours on it so far. And then this. And we'll see what else pops up. Have a good one.
Okay, so this has been turning for roughly an hour. I lost track of time watching TV. It's so pretty in person. The screens just don't do it justice. You can see that kind of texture there. Not so much right there, but that's all right. I don't want it to be uniform throughout. Just gives it such a cool, different look. So, anyways, that is that. I'm going to set the timer now for a couple of hours, let it turn, and that's that. Like I said, if you think of something cool to put on there for the vinyl, I can't talk, I'm ready for bed, please leave it in the comments. Have a good one.